I am Hydlight of RegionalExperience.com. In this video, I'm going to talk mainly about LFOs inside of the subvector, where LFO stands for low frequency oscillator. And usually it is not in sync with the keyboard. At least it doesn't really trigger like a normal oscillator would do. Like these oscillators over here, these are usually in sync with the keyboard, unless you turn these settings off. That's KBD, that's keyboard tracking, if you will. And an LFO is kind of like a stubborn thing that basically does its own thing based on a frequency, where the frequency can either be in sync with, let's say, the tempo, or it's like a free-running thing. And there are two different LFOs out there that sit inside of the subvector by default. You have LFO 1 and you have LFO 2, where LFO 2 is a little bit like differently and odd at times, but the LFO, because the LFO 2 does not have, for instance, a syncing method, it also does not allow you to change the pattern. The pattern is fixed, it's all based on a triangle, not as a sine wave, as some people may assume that it is. It's not the sine wave, it's a triangle form. And it also comes with different settings that the LFO 1, for instance, does not have. There's a reason behind that, why that is. And I will explain like why that is later. The LFO 1 over here is ideal to make changes within the sound that is based on, let's say, tempo synchronized stuff. Like over here, you have a thing that's called syncing. Then I can turn this whole thing into, let's say, a type of chiptune sound, if you will. Let's go for that route. Let's create that. We'll reset this device. We'll set up two different sounds. It's going to be two times a square wave tone. And what we're going to do is tremolo this thing from lower octave to higher octave using a setting that's called the mix knob, which is located over there. Remember, this is oscillator 1 playing, this is oscillator 2 playing. So at this extent, I could do something like this and that and this and that and this and that really fast, but using a LFO instead. We'll sync this up with the tempo. We'll take a waveform that's going to be the square tone, which is located right there, which means that this position knob will go like this, and then that, and then this, and that, this, that. So it goes up and down like crazy. I can set an amount all the way to open and set this thing to mix, which basically does the exact same thing that I just explained. But in this case, it's being handled through a pattern, which is over there. The rate determines like how fast that pattern will change. So if I press one note, oh, I have to turn the oscillator 2 on. If I enable oscillator 2, press one note, almost sounds like an ambulance that's taking off. There goes the ambulance. But then I can turn this into, let's say, my chiptune sound, going like that, right all the way to open. Ideal in this particular case would be going for a legato setup, a little bit portamento setup over there, have one polyphonic, and then I can do these type of... Oh, let's crank this thing all the way open. Hold on. Now I'm going to be on a roll over. Let's turn this thing off, filter envelope, open the filter all the way open. Instant chiptune sound. I mean, the only thing that I'm doing is I'm constantly flip-flopping back and forth from oscillator 1 to oscillator 2 using the mix setting over there. But in case you want to have a more like a pad type of setup, that can also be arranged, going to go for a subtractor patch. Again, reset this device, since we're talking about subtractors anyways. Make a little bit movement inside of the phase setting over here, inside of oscillator 2. Drop that one octave. Focus mostly on oscillator 1, so this one will become a little bit like a subtle effect in the background. Use a little bit attack on the phase over here, which currently sounds like this. That's a sweeping effect that's taking place. Using a phase setting, But then I can also apply a LFO over here and use that to control the mix with a random curve, which is in this case the lowest oscillator that sits inside of the LFO. This means that the value from the mix knob is constantly changing in a random state, but it goes gradually. It's like drift. Set an amount right there. There you go. It constantly moves from higher octave, lower octave, higher octave, lower octave, but it does that gradually. And depending on like what the rate is doing, I can also make this slow moving like this. And I can listen to these sounds all day. Then again, LFO can also be handy for creating drift type of sounds. Kind of like mimicking the behavior that we are creating, let's say, an analog type of synthesizer. For instance, if you have two different saw waves like this on the same exact octave setting, I can also apply drift on the second oscillator, which is located over there, LFO1. Use that. I'm going to go for the free running thing. Use a little bit amount over there, right here. And then again, use the drift setting over there. This is actually overdoing the setting. Here you're going to hear what's going to happen with the pitch. But in this case, if I do it really subtle, let's say amount of 7. It's almost like a detuning that constantly varies over time. Thus, that makes it kind of like evolve in pitch. But in case you don't really like this artifact one bit, that it's too fast, you can also slow it down, of course, making the movement slower. Still have it there. The waveform is constantly changing and always dynamic, and it will never sound exactly the same because the pitch changes are going to vary from one to another in time. That's the whole idea there. This kind of brings me to another setting, that is LFO2. And LFO2 has one odd behavior, and that is one thing that's called KBD over there. Where you may think to yourself, like, what does keyboard tracking do inside of an LFO? Because normally a keyboard tracking system is based on pitches within the oscillator itself. In this particular context, KBD means changing the rate inside of the LFO2 itself. So if I would crank open the KBD setting all the way to open, set an amount over here, I'm going to set these things to phase over here on both oscillators, drop the octave over there, set these both on subtractive phase over there. In this case, I have full control on like how much phasing is going to be applied on it using an LFO and how fast that thing goes throughout the whole complete keyboard range. If I go for a lower octave, sounds like that. It moves. Yeah. Go for a high octave, then the rate will go much faster. As you can see right there. So in this case, it goes along with the pitch changes that go with it. So the higher I go, the faster that phase momentum will go. Just like that. This is ideal, especially if you have a sound that needs to play chords, for instance, but you want to have a light variation between every note that takes place within the sound itself. So let's just do that. We'll stick in a scales and chords, make it really dramatic, going for lower octave, higher octave, open the chord right there, because then I'm going to create these really big chords, of course. I'm going to select over here C minor. And the next thing that I'll do over here is turn this into, again, a little bit like a pad type of sound, going like this. And if I press a key right now, there's a lot of movement taking place. Without this setting over here, without the KBD over here, the movement will constantly be the same on every note. But if I set the KBD all the way to open, I'm having a slight variation of phasing that's taking place per note inside of one chord. So the higher notes go faster, while the lower notes will go slower. So the lower notes go like, while the higher notes go, that type of thing. I have no other way to put it. Sometimes I sound weird. Same thing could be said for amplitude. Amplitude is nothing more than opening up and closing down the volume. Same deal. So in this case, I'm actually making movement throughout the whole complete chord, going from low to high. And sometimes the lower notes are off, sometimes the higher notes are off. So I'm constantly moving throughout the whole complete chord using an LFO. I can make it even more dramatic by taking the amount all the way to open. Which makes it really drastic. But then you're going to hear what's going to happen, because all those on-off states are going to be varying per note. That's more or less the idea there. And these type of things can sometimes be handy. For instance, if you get to throw in something like pitch. Pitch can also be handled using a KBD setting. But in this case, I will go for a little bit like a delay amount. Because what will happen in this case is that once I start hitting a key and I take a next key, it will take some time before the LFO 2 will kick in. So first you have like a stable note that goes like constant. And then once the delay has done a thing, the LFO starts to kick in. And then all of a sudden I'm adding a vibrato on top of the sound itself, which can be quite interesting from time to time. I have actually done a couple of songs with this technique in particular. Going from a sine wave, going to go for a normal subtractive, normal sound with no phasing taking place whatsoever. So it's going to be a straightforward sine wave. This is without. I will do the first thing without. Sounds like that. Oh, I'm going to create a lead, sorry. That's without, right? There's no vibration taking place whatsoever. But as soon as I start opening up this amount over here, I can add a little bit like a vibrato taking place. Also decrease the delay amount right there, so the vibrato takes place a little bit faster. But so if I do it like this, sometimes I'm creating that effect and sometimes I don't, because that's all handled through the delay times. And it depends like how I'm timing things on my keyboard right now. So sometimes these notes may have a vibrato, or sometimes they do. Same thing could be said for tremolo. I'm going to crank open the Yamaha right there. And the higher I go, the more that goes on, the faster it goes. They can actually hear the difference. I think everybody's fell to sleep at this point. Anyways, that's all about LFOs that I had to cover right now. In the next video, I'm going to talk a little bit more about the velocity changes that can be applied and the mod wheel controller that can be applied using different settings. Have lots of fun. I will talk to you later.